Today, it's a 2013 Coyote Mustang. We're chasing the stock engine and transmission record. That record is an 867 at 156 miles an hour, is the mile an hour mark. When we bought this car, it was originally I bought it to essentially learn how to tune the newer platform. I feel like if I'm going to be fluent in tuning a car, I really need to own it so I can know all the ins and outs of the software, learn them on my own pace. So this is an automatic 6R80. I bought the car sight unseen from a dealership in New York. You'd be really surprised how hard it was to find a grabber blue 6R80, like an automatic Coyote car. There were three for sale in the country at the time I found this one. This was, again, at a dealership out of New York. It showed up in the beginning of winter, covered in salt on the back of an open trailer. It was like the most nerve-wracking thing ever. First thing we did, obviously, drive it to the car wash, knock all the salt off of it. But it's a, that was an interesting experience. The car stock out of the box, I remember my first time to the track with it. I can't remember what the car ET, low 13s, like 108 mile an hour, 109 mile an hour. The very first pass I made, I roll up next to a Taurus, SHO Taurus, and I'm like, man, I got this guy. This will be cool. I'll win the first race I'm in, you know? I mean, a little feat, but whatever. And then that Taurus just gaffed me. I mean, he had 3-4 car lengths off me in the eighth. I think he went like a 1260, something like that. I was running him down, but just couldn't get there. So that interesting little tidbit there. The car morphed into a few things. We went from an NA build. We went the best of an 11, I believe a 38 at 119 with the car, naturally aspirated. We were doing a little bit of bracket racing. You'll see I'll show a picture of the cold air intake we built. We laid the radiator back to like here and ran the throttle body inlet in front of the radiator because we had a big problem with air temperature inconsistencies and we had tried to bracket race the car from time to time. After that, we put a plate kit, a nitrous outlets plate kit on it, a progressive controller. We went a 1030 something. I have the slip, I'll post a picture of the slip. Good running car. Low 10 second street car was on E85, had a Boss intake manifold that we had ported in house, Cooks like their mid-length header, handmade exhaust system the rest of the way back, and billet oil pump gears. That was all the car had done to it. Had a Circle D 4C converter in it at the time, still was first gear leave, the rear end is just welded tube. Nothing special. That was I believe that was on a 28-10-5 tire. Nothing too crazy. Pretty basic setup to go deep tens in it. The car with me in it was 3,980 pounds, just shy of 4,000 pounds. The car is very heavy. Another thing we did with the car in 2016, we actually did drag week with the car when it was a naturally aspirated car with oxide. Now we didn't have a cage in it at the time, so we were stuck at 1150 mark, which we went, I think we averaged like a 58 through the week NA, which was cool. The drag week experience was just something we wanted to do. I don't know if we'll go back and do it again. It'd have to be more of a challenge. We'd have to run like small watt power at or something, 850 certs. The driving a, you know, newer Mustang around, AC, pump gas, gets 21 miles a gallon, runs mid-11s was really... It was cool to experience, but it wasn't a challenge. It was very easy. The car NA with the Boss intake manifold, ported Boss intake manifold on E85 and headers, made 431 to the tire through the automatic stock. It made 356 to the tire. So we gained quite a bit from an intake manifold, headers, and fuel change. On the nitrous setup, the car made, I'm trying to remember, we made a little over 600 foot-pounds of torque. I think it was 608 foot-pounds of torque and 572 horsepower. That's when we went that 1030 pass on that. So, good runner in both situations. 430 to the tire, NA is a pretty decent number for a Coyote. It's not a Boss where it's a CNC ported head, and it's still a Gen 1, so that was a 412 flywheel number stock. So definitely happy with the NA numbers we made with the car. Again, it went like an 1130, was its best ET naturally aspirated. So yeah, that's pretty much how we got from where we started to, buying our daily driver to the nitrous setup to the next step to that was building our turbo setup. So the next video I'm gonna post will be a bunch of pictures of the turbo build. It's a pretty unique header being a 180 degree header design. It has an air to water intake manifold that I built myself. The heat exchangers in the bottom of the intake manifold. Pretty unique setup, so I'm gonna spend some time talking about that in the next video. But for now, that's the first time from when we bought the car till when we decided to put the turbo setup on the car. So if you guys enjoyed it, subscribe and check out the next video.